Hi everybody, this is Betty from Casa Chiesi, and today is a very ugly and rainy day in Milan, so we decided to show you how to make chocolate mousse, which is one of our favorite desserts. We have our ingredients already prepared. So we start with 175 grams of dark chocolate, 250 grams of fresh cream, 1.5 sheet of fish gelatin, 125 grams of fresh milk, 1 vanilla pod, and some ribes.
Which is a red currant for those that don't know, but it's also called ribes around the world.
Okay. Just in case you missed the ingredients, you can find them listed on the wall.
Hey, lovely handwriting.
You don't understand, my dear. I'm a corrected left-handed, so it's a miracle you can read it. The first thing you have to do is to soften your fish gelatin. To do so, you have to use cold water, otherwise the gelatin melts and you have just to soften it. For those of you that are vegetarian or vegan, you cannot use this because it's called fish gelatin, but actually it's made out of pork. So the equivalent is agar-agar. It has the same function, but it's made out of seaweed. So it's good for people that don't eat meat. So we need, for this recipe, just 1.5. So we cut it, we can manage, we cut it, okay. And we put it in the water. It takes about 10 minutes to soften. We put it on the side and we go ahead with the rest of the recipe. Second step, you take your vanilla pod and you cut it in the center. If you don't have a vanilla pod, you can use vanilla flavor, which is, a little bit more fake, a little stronger, but hey, if it's necessary, it works.
Yeah, one's got to do what one's got to do.
Yeah. With the tip of the knife, you get all the seeds from the pod, you see? And you put them in a pot. Make sure you get all of them. Okay. And you pour your milk. That makes the sip a little bit. Now, we warm up our milk. Okay. You don't have to boil it. It doesn't have to boil. It has to be very warm. And we chop our chocolate. This is 70% dark chocolate. And it's very important that the chocolate is good because at the end of the day, you only have whipped cream and chocolate in this recipe. So if the chocolate is not good and the cream is not good, the mousse is not going to be good. So don't be stingy and buy good chocolate. For those of you that really like sweet things, in this recipe there is no sugar, but if you have, let's say, 85% dark chocolate, maybe you can add a little bit of sugar, but in this recipe there is no sugar. Okay, you start chopping. Doesn't have to be very, very fine, but this is a very pleasant sensation because you have all this chocolate.
Therapeutic, I would say.
Yes. It's raining outside. It's Sunday afternoon. Nothing exciting is happening, so it's beautiful to have all this chocolate to cut. While you do this, maybe you leave a little bit on the side because I'll show you why. Okay, let's separate the chocolate and put it aside. I put it in a small bowl. In the meantime, our milk is hot, not boiling, remember. Okay, it has to be hot. And we get the fish gelatin. We have to squeeze it to get rid of the extra water. You see, it's not melted. It's just soft. Okay, you put it in the milk and stir to melt it. And we add our chocolate. Now the milk is still hot. It's very little. It's 125 grams. It's very little, but enough to melt the chocolate. Okay, you stir until it's very creamy.
That is looking really good already.
Chocolate. The medicine of all the pains. It has to be really, really smooth. And then you let it there, you let it cool down. And while it cools down, we can whip the cream. Okay, it's almost done. You see how it's nice and smooth with a very little bit of of milk? Okay. We whip the cream now. It's better now. We kept it on the table because we have to show you the ingredients, but keep the cream in the fridge until the last minute. Anyway, now we whip the cream. The process is going to be very noisy, so we're going to show you at the end. Just remember that it has to be very nice and thick. Ready, it has to stick to the ball. Okay, when the cream is whipped and the chocolate has cooled down, you can add the chocolate, but you have to do it this way, you know, from the bottom to avoid that the whipped cream collapses.
So it's a very subtle movement.
Yes. Gentle and slow. You add it all and mix. And now that the cream is done, you are ready to make your portions. But try to use a small cup because this is a very rich recipe. So at the end of the meal, you don't want to be heavy with a big dessert. You start pouring, let's say half of the cup. And then, you remember the chocolate that we put on the side? You can put a little bit of chocolate inside, because it's going to give you a little extra texture to the mousse. And then you keep on pouring. Don't make it completely full. Second one. With this amount of ingredients, you can end up having 5 cups of mousse.
They're kind of small cups, these portions.
Yeah, but it's strong, you know, it's a lot of chocolate, a lot of cream. And you should manage to make 2 extra cups. You put them in the fridge, and for those that are really greedy, you have extra mousse for them. So I'm gonna show you how they will look when they we'll spend a good 6 hours in the fridge. 4 hours could be enough, but the more you let them inside the fridge, the better it is, because you give the time to the fish gelatin to get hard. And then you can decorate the way you want. For instance, you can pour a little bit of Powdered sugar.
That's cute.
And some fruit.
And this is the rebus, but
This is ribis.
you can
We
use
can use
raspberry,
blueberry, raspberry,
blueberries.
whatever you
Great.
like. For instance, raspberry is very good with chocolate. It's a very good combination. But this is cute, it's nice and tasty. In my opinion, this cup is a little bit too big. This would be the right size. So enjoy also the part of the decoration, which is always very nice with desserts, and hope you like it. This is all from Kazakiski for today. Ciao.